Hello, everybody. It's Aaron D. Hart with Summit Funding. I'm here at Coldwell Banker in Reno, Nevada. I'm with my good friend and realtor extraordinaire, Ron Bell. Ron, come on in, buddy. How you doing today?
Oh, good. How are you?
I wanted to talk to Ron today about some of his success that he does using social media and using the internet. Ron gets quite a lot of volume from his website, renohomevoices.com, correct?
renohomevoices.com. Reno Home Voices, or just my name, rondellrealtor.com, or about 90 other domains pointing to my sites.
Ron gets a ton of traffic, and he gets a ton of phone calls and questions about buying a home. And I've had the pleasure of working with Ron for quite some time, and very professional, very great. So I just wanted to kind of take a second and ask Ron, especially we have a huge first-time home buyers market here in the Reno Sparks area. So I just wanted to take a second and ask Ron what his initial conversations are like and how he helps prepare these first-time home buyers when they do contact you, what kind of questions they have, and what is it that they're looking for. So fire away, Ron.
Well, after I get through the normal things, you know, what kind of house are you looking for, bedrooms, bath, you know, one-story, two-story, the usual things, I try to at least find out, of course, if they're going to qualify for this. Because a lot of people, they don't realize how tough it's got. But with FHAs, a lot of times people don't realize how actually easy it is. So there can be some misconceptions on both sides of the fence. So we really want to find out, hey, you know, has there been a foreclosure, has there been a short sale, loss of job? I obviously are very experienced, you know, knowing what you guys are looking for, but I'm going to ultimately hand them off to you. But I want to get a good financial picture of these people so I know kind of preliminarily what to look for. And at that point, I am going to probably go ahead and then, after I talk to them, give them your number or email address or something like that, and then hand them off to you so you can get a good financial snapshot. I'll probably send them away with a lot of homes that they can go drive by and look at. The thing is, what I try to get them to do is of course, get pre-approved first. Mm-hmm. And we look at them on the internet, blow up all the pictures, pull up a Google map. Mm-hmm. And then I try to get them to drive by first. Because especially a lot of these bank loans, they're pretty fast-moving ones. Mm-hmm. Or maybe they'll get there and they're trashed or something like that. Meanwhile, while they're trying to at least get a picture of their pre-approval, what you don't want to do as a buyer, and also to fellow agents, is just instantly hop in the car, start driving all around town, and they can't even qualify for that house.
Sure.
Or they can qualify for something nicer, and everybody wasted their time. What I guess I'll throw this back at you. What are you looking for if I was to send you a first-time buyer, for example?
Sure. Well, the biggest thing is obviously is I kind of equate it to a chair. A chair has four legs, and the biggest four factors that lenders are looking for nowadays to qualify people is your cash, credit, income, and then also the property itself. When I say cash, that's obviously the amount of money that someone has invested into the transaction.
Yes.
So their down payment, funds to close, credits. Pretty much every lender now that's looking at FHA loans wants a minimum middle FICO score of 640. So that means you have three different scores from each of the bureaus. We're going to use the middle score and throw out the high and the low to qualify. Income, obviously, is not just how much money they make, but we're also looking at their total liability structure, debt-to-income ratios, and also job history. We want to typically have someone that's been in the same line of work, same field for at least 2 years. Doesn't mean they can't have changed jobs in that two-year period, but it still needs to be in the same career path or same line of work. Then obviously the property. You know, the banks, the lenders, we want to make sure that the property that we're financing is actually worth what it's worth that the people are going to buy it for, and that it's also safe for the buyers to live in. So those are the big four factors that we look at. Obviously documentation that you want to have prepared. It's super full documentation now, so we need to see everything, but it's typically going to be your last 2 years W-2s, your last 2 years tax returns. If you're self-employed, last 2 years tax returns, plus all your required schedules that go along with that. Your last 2 months of bank statements, all the pages, especially even if the last one says intentionally left blank, they do want that too. And basically any kind of letters of any hiccups or anything that might have happened in your past that we might need to explain to an underwriter, you know, in regards to credit or and basically why you want to purchase a house, what's your motivation for it. So obviously important, you know, to have people pre-approved, and that's you know, one of the biggest. So I think the biggest takeaway is if you're getting ready to buy a house and you want to look at it, you definitely want to meet with your lender and make sure that you're properly pre-approved and have all your ducks in a row, so to speak, to be able to go out and shopping for a home.
And, you know, people take a little bit of an offense sometimes, like, well, my credit's great and this and that.
Sure.
You never know when, well, worst case scenario, the identity theft.
Absolutely.
I've had a number of people that, and I'm sure you see it all the time,
yeah,
where something got hacked, you know, or something slipped through the crack. It's supposed to be on auto pay. Next thing you know, it's 30 days
yeah.
late. So we're not telling people, like, look, we don't trust your word.
Right.
It's just that things happen, and we need to get a financial snapshot and see what they get approved for. Similar if you go to a car lot, for example.
Sure.
You want to know if you're going to go out and look at the Lexus or the Camry.
Absolutely.
You know, you need to know what you can afford, and that's really all we're trying to do here. You know, we probably want to keep this video fairly short. You got anything else to add to that?
I just wanted to piggyback what you were saying on credit. It is important. They actually report that almost 80%, that's 8 out of 10 credit reports, either have inaccurate or old information that shouldn't be on there that can actually affect your score. So that's something you want to check out as well.
Yeah, and I'll throw this out. You want to go to annualcreditreports.com. I'm going to repeat that again. Annualcreditreports.com. I don't know if it's singular or plural, but just make sure you get on the right one. It's completely free. The score is going to cost you extra, but just go for the free one. And then actually you can dispute right from there also. So that's very important. You get all three bureaus once a year for free. And if you've been denied, of course, you get them for free too. RondellRealtor.com, 775-750-5256. What's your contact?
Aaron DeHart with Summit Funding here in Reno, Nevada. I can be reached at 775-824-3640, extension 104. And you can also find me on my blog, www.thenevadamortgagereports.com. Have a good day, everybody.
Let me add one more thing. One of the reasons I partnered up with Aaron, I don't know if you call it a partnership or what, but Aaron, you know, myself is what I strive for, too. We answer our phone and return our emails. We work full-time, and what time are you in the office? Say 6.
Yeah.
So, yeah, this guy makes me tired just looking at his schedule. You know, I tend to work late. He tends to get up early and work late. So we're around, and you guys can get a hold of us anytime. Thanks, guys.
Bye. Have a great day.